Welcome back once again, friends. We are in lesson number 63. In lesson number 62, we saw the pixelate effect. In this video, we will see another interesting graphic effect, which is called the mosaic effect. And we will make a mosaic of sprites using this. In fact, this can be used in a very effective manner to do some really interesting stuff. Let's get started and take a look. So for this purpose, I have created a very simple project where I have used this sprite called skeleton and I put it in wood. So little bit scary probably, but let's see what all can happen here, right? So first let's start with something that we've learned before. Let's make this skeleton dance by just using several costumes, right? Notice this has got some interesting costumes. So, you know, it kind of twists and turns and it creates a very nice effect, right? So let's start with that since we've done this before. So I'll say when the flag is lit, switch to skeleton A. Thereafter, I'll say forever, let's say wait for maybe say 0.3 seconds and go to a next costume, right? So, you know, if I did this, it's quite interesting by itself. Notice the skeleton appears to sort of do a dance, right? Now, let's say I do something more than this, right? So, let's say I use this effect called the mosaic effect, right? So, what I'll do is that I'll go to the skeleton and I'll say in the looks, I'll go and say set mosaic effect to say, so I'll basically say switch costumes, you know, so let me switch the costume first and then I'll say set mosaic effect to, let's say 25, right? Now what this will do is that it will create a 4x4 grid of skeletons and all of them will start doing this, right? Now this is really it's like a trick that's going on. Remember, these graphic effects are just some kind of a layer on top of the sprite, right? So they are not really like new sprites getting created, but just look at this, see how this goes, right? And it looks so amazingly good, right? Because we have got, now we've got 4x4 skeletons here and they're all doing this dance, and this looks kind of like bit nice in a way. You can in fact make them move as well, right? So let's say I did this 36, so 36 will give me 5x5, right? And notice now I get a 5x5 and they are all dancing. It looks pretty cool. Let's say along with next costume I also added a little bit of a motion, right? So that can also be done. So let's say I just say move by say one step, right? But now the moment I do this, I must make sure that I put this go to block so that they start from a known position, right? So let's say I'll say go to say -100 and Y is fine, right? So now notice what happens. They will also slowly, very slowly they are moving, and you can see that here, they're also kind of moving towards the right. They're all moving together, right? So it's really just one sprite. It's not like there are some 16 or 25 sprites here. It's the same sprite, but it has taken a costume which has got like multiple, mosaic of it, right? So that's the mosaic effect. You can use it to create march past effects. You can use it to, you know, create some really fantastic things, as you can imagine, right? So I hope you found this useful. Take care. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.